What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Scoopduck YouTube channel. If you're new here, I'm Max Torres with Scoopduck. Consider hitting the like and subscribe button. Before we get into the main topic in today's video, I want to update everyone on a little bit of news. I spoke with Oregon quarterback commit Ty Thompson earlier today, and he told me that he's going to be enrolling early at the University of Oregon. So that's looking like, you know, right around that winter timeline, early January. That's always huge when you can get your quarterback on campus early, get him in the system, and get him learning the offense as quickly and as early as possible so he can, you know, I don't think he's going to be competing for, you know, the starting spot with Tyler Shuck already in the system and Anthony Brown as well, but always good nonetheless to have him on campus early. I will have a full write-up about that conversation up on the site in the near future. Might already be up by the time you're viewing this video, but wanted to update everyone on that. The main subject in today's video is 2024 Oregon baseball commit Gabe Howard from Westland High School in the Portland, Oregon area. Yeah, you heard that right. 2024, Gabe is just starting his freshman year of high school, and he's already locked in with Oregon with his verbal commitment. So, you know, nothing's official until you put that pen to paper, but he is a great player. He's going to be hopefully going two ways for the Ducks here. He's primarily a pitcher, right-hander, and he also plays outfield. He is just entering his freshman year, but his velocity on his fastball is coming in at 84 miles an hour, and he's developing a curveball. He's also a high caliber player because he represented Team USA on the national scale, the international scale, I should say. So he does have experience playing with Team USA, and that's a huge distinction for any kind of player. I talked to Gabe about, you know, why he committed to Oregon, what his near future, immediate future is looking like with baseball, and you know what he's hearing from Oregon. So with all that said, I want to hop into that interview, and I'll see you guys after. All right, now I want to welcome in 2024 Oregon baseball commit Gabe Howard, coming at us from Westland, Oregon. Gabe, how's it going, man? Thanks for joining us.
It's going great. How are you?
I'm great. Excited to, you know, get into this interview and kind of continue the baseball coverage here on the site and on the channel. Yep. Interested to see kind of what you guys are all about. So starting off, I know you committed to Oregon just a little while ago. Why did you decide to choose Oregon? And, you know, why did you commit now so early?
Yeah, we went to the campus. We saw the campus, the field. We loved it. It was perfect. I've been talking with the coaches for 2 months now, and I've gotten to really know them. And they really fit my personality perfect and my style of play. So I just got to know them more, and they fit me. So there was nowhere else I wanted to be. It just fit perfect.
Yeah, talk a little bit about that fit. You know, some of the coaches that you're talking to at Oregon, and then maybe kind of how they plan to use you in the program as far as on the field.
So yeah, 4 years out from college, they know I'm gonna keep developing. They're gonna help me through that. We stay in touch. Jake Andier is the pitching coach there, and he's gonna keep calling with me throughout my high school, and just keep helping me develop throughout all high school until I'm ready to be on that Oregon campus and playing for them.
Very cool. I think it's a unique situation since, like you were saying, you know, it's so early, but they'll kind of be helping you along in your development. And, you know, just getting more people to help you kind of hone in on your craft. That's got to be really cool. So since you are so early in the process, when you were going through, you know, the recruitment, when did you actually get that Oregon offer?
Before I was committing. So I probably got the offer about 3 weeks before I committed. And it was really exciting. I've grown up around Oregon and Oregon football, Oregon baseball, and it was just a dream come true.
Awesome. Yeah, I definitely want to get into that, representing Oregon a little bit later in the interview. But so you got the offer, you know, quick process, you know, made that decision, you were feeling comfortable. Were there any other schools involved in your recruitment? Anyone else you were talking to? And has anyone, you know, reached out since?
Yeah, for sure. I've been in touch with a few other colleges, but none of them compared to Oregon. Just growing up around the school, it's been a dream come true. So there's nowhere else I would want to be besides Oregon.
Very cool. Yeah. Cool to see you make that decision and, you know, be representing your state. I'm still getting used to, you know, the whole baseball coverage and how that works. Yeah. I know that you're listed as a right-handed pitcher slash outfielder. Talk a little bit about your primary position.
So right now, my primary will be a pitcher, and then my secondary will be an outfielder. So right now is my commitment. I'm an outfielder and pitcher, but I could definitely see myself progressing more towards a pitcher throughout my college.
Awesome. Yeah, I had Ian Umlant on here the other day. He's another guy that's supposed to pitch for the Ducks, and it was cool to kind of get his story, his side of things, because I was a pitcher when I played Little League. I played all the way up until high school. I want to learn a little bit about kind of your play style. Tell me a little bit about, you know, the kind of pitches that you throw, and then maybe a little bit about your approach and routine on the mound.
Yeah, right now I have a fastball, changeup, and slider, and then developing with the curveball. But I love to attack hitters, just first pitch fastball as a strike, and then move it from there to slider. But if obviously they're bigger hitters, I'm going to move them with a slider first and work them in a backwards count.
Okay, yeah, attacking right off the bat. I like the mindset. You know, we were talking a little bit about your pitch types, and I was looking at your perfect game profile, and you've been adding some speed recently. What's the velocity you're working with right now, and you know, how have you improved recently?
So last year, last summer, I was sitting at about 78, 79 miles an hour, and this year working with my trainer is Kevin Gunderson. He's helped me develop to sit at 84 now. So it's definitely been a bump up from last year.
Yeah, I know a lot of people, you know, especially with pitchers, that's probably one of the biggest things that they're looking at is, you know, velocity and speed. What are some of the exercises or training kind of things that you do to add that velocity?
So with Kevin Gunderson, it's a lot of working on the form and making sure you're sitting perfect, not messing up with throughout your perfection of pitching. It's not all about getting strength, but you definitely have to keep getting strength stronger, but a lot of it is form.
Yeah. I think that kind of goes hand in hand with how a lot of people think, you know, if someone's a big hitter, it's all, you know, the upper body, but you know, for people that, you know, learn more about the game, it's, you know, it's in the hips and a lot of power is from your legs. And, you know, talking about you as a pitcher, I know you mentioned that you like attacking. How do you kind of view, you know, the pitcher is the guy who controls the pace of the game. You know, you do the pickoffs if you need to. You can step off and kind of compose yourself. Talk about how you deal with the game mentally and kind of manage it.
There's a lot of players that love to get rowdy and try and startle the pitcher. But for me, I'm a very calm and collected kid on the mound. I love to control the game and make sure everyone's calm and not just getting overwhelmed and getting pressured. So I definitely take command and slow down the game if it's needed to be.
Gotcha. Yeah, and there's a lot of, you know, unique things that people can do to try to take control of the game. Do you have like a favorite part of baseball or something that you do all the time on game day that gets you hyped up?
There's not something that mainly we try and get hyped up, but it's definitely, we play a lot of the same kids and we know there's a lot of competitiveness around them. And it's a lot of trash talk before games too. They love to get rowdy and try and fire us up so we mess up, but we take it straight to them.
Yeah, the trash talk, I think that's something that's so unique when it comes to baseball. You know, when I was playing, I was a pitcher myself, you got the other dugout, you know, trying to rowdy you up and, you know, chirping at you. And then right before you deliver the pitch, that's when everyone kind of has to, you know, cut it out. How do you kind of take that and, you know, compose yourself?
It's always, I love to see their faces after the first pitch that I throw, because they see how hard I'm throwing, they love to be quiet after that, because once their first batter gets out, they all know they're done for.
Right on. Well, I love the confidence. It's definitely something that makes you settle in. When you hear that glove pop, you're like, wow, this guy's throwing some gas. So that's super cool to hear about. You mentioned earlier, you know, being from the state of Oregon, it's been a dream of yours to come to Oregon. Talk a little bit about what it means to you to be able to represent your home state at the next level.
Yeah. Even Coach Wozniakowski, the head coach, he came to me when we called. He said he wants to get guys to represent the Northwest. And I love that saying. I want to be here. I want to be able to, you know, we had Peyton Pritchard for basketball. He came from Westland too. And he showed up for basketball and represented the entire Northwest. So I want to be that next guy.
Yeah, you talk about representing, you know, the Northwest. Tell me a little bit about what the baseball culture is like for those of us that, you know, don't really know about it here in Oregon or the Northwest itself.
It's definitely a small lifestyle. It's, you know, everyone, you've played everyone here. It's, you know, the guys, you know, the dudes that are going to be the competitive ones and how they're going to challenge you, but you always, you got to be the guy that shows up and takes it to them and beats them.
Absolutely, yeah. It's a whole different type of game, and it's
Yeah.
interesting to learn more about the culture and, you know, what goes into the game, even off the field. So that's super
Yeah.
cool. I know. I think there's a picture of you. It might be your Twitter picture right now, where you're playing for Team USA. You know, throwing on the mound for them. Tell me a little bit about what it's been like, you know, going to represent them and what that experience has been like.
Yeah, obviously right now it's a little hard to go to those tournaments because we're in quarantine, kind of locked down. But before it was really exciting. We got to go to the North Carolina, their facility, their big one. And it's just representing your country now. It's a big step up from representing Oregon. It was really exciting to go to meet all the players from all the way around the country, and even another one, Kai Halstead from Washington. We met up. We've played each other now. We know each other pretty well now.
Awesome. Yeah, I think that's one of the coolest parts about, you know, sports is, especially as a recruit, you know, getting to travel and you make all these new friends, you
Yeah.
have all these cool experiences. So that's awesome. One thing I'm interested to know, especially with baseball, that I think makes it very unique, you did commit very early, but baseball is one of the sports where we can see people go directly out of high school into the pros. Tell me a little bit about your thoughts on that, you know, potentially going pro. I don't know about your specific situation, but just, you know, the idea of going pro versus going to Oregon, is there any kind of benefits that come to mind?
Yeah, that's really hard to wrap my mind around right now. But I know Mick Abel, he went 15th pick in the MLB draft, and he's from Oregon, and he went straight out of high school. I've definitely been in the facility with him, been around him, and just seeing how he throws. It's definitely something to think about, but it's kind of crazy to wrap your head around right now at 14.
Yeah, wow, 14, and you already know where you're going to college. That's
Yeah.
something. Did you know, being so young, did your parents, you know, you have to sit down with them and kind of, you know, reason out why it makes sense to make the move now?
It was a lot of talking with them. That's why we waited 3 weeks for the commitment after the offer. We were sitting down every night talking about what would make sense, what would fit perfect for me, and we always came back to how their personality at Oregon fit me perfect, and it worked out perfect. Yeah.
Cool. It's interesting to, you know, learn about that process and kind of what goes into making that decision. It's not, you know, just you have your family members involved, and I'm sure
Yeah.
your coaches were involved in that as well.
We sat down on a Zoom meeting with all the coaches. They got to meet the family. It's a little tough with family because my sister, she's actually going to be a Beaver next year. And so we have that rivalry in the family now.
Oh, getting that right. So I want, does that, do you think your parents are going to, I've kind of seen some Oregon fans, parents rather, they kind of go with like the split jersey. If something like, do you think your
Yeah.
parents might do that?
Yeah, I'm thinking the split outfit. You got Beaver shorts and then duck shirt, or the other way around.
Very cool. Well, it's nice to know that your parents are, you know, going to be supporting you guys either
Yeah.
way. We were talking about this a little bit before I hit record. You also play, you know, some football. Talk about what that has been like, playing football. You know, do you plan to play at Westland, and how does that maybe translate into baseball?
Right now it's football recruiting happens way later in high school, and I'm definitely gonna keep playing throughout my high school. It helps me going into baseball season. Football, it keeps me conditioned, keeps me in shape, make sure I'm not tired on the base path. It really helps just being tough and physical. You can bring it all the way to baseball.
Cool. Yeah, and you know, on this channel, we do a lot of football stuff. Is there a particular aspect of football that you enjoy, or any other benefits that you see coming from playing football as well?
What I love from football is just I'm wide receiver right now, and I love just getting past people, getting rough with them, and throwing to the ground and going to score that touchdown and winning. Winning's a big part. I love being competitive, and it definitely shows in baseball.
Cool. Yeah, I talk to a lot of athletes, and you know, we see these people. I since we're talking about, you know, quarantine times, and that's a big topic right now. I don't know if you watched The Last Dance, but like we saw MJ and like how crazy competitive he was. Do you kind of see like your side yourself like that competitor, like no matter what it is, you want to win?
Yeah, for sure. It's me and my friend Ryan. He's committed to the Beavs right now. We're both 24 grads, and I'm 14, he's 15 now. We're really competitive with each other, so it helps us grow throughout our years because he's playing at Westland with me as well.
Gotcha. Yeah, so, you know, getting after it even off the field is always super cool to see. Now, I mean, obviously we're focusing on the athletic side of things. You're just starting high school, but I want to learn a little bit about you off the field. Do you have any, you know, kind of major in mind? What do you like to do with your free time?
For college majors, I'm definitely thinking the business side of communications. I'm a very talkative person, fun to be around. I was thinking more of a communication job, but also I'm very adventurous. I love going on hikes. Boating is a big part. I love wakeboarding. Going to trips, traveling is super fun. That comes with baseball as well. You get to travel everywhere, meet different people, and go to different places.
Awesome. Yeah, I just moved to Eugene a couple weeks ago, but I've been able to explore the state a little bit, and I got to say, Oregon's a beautiful state.
Yeah, it's crazy here. The weather is a big part here too.
Oh yeah.
You never know what you're gonna get.
Yeah, I did my undergrad up in Spokane in Eastern Washington, and that was some pretty hectic weather. But you know, looking at you, and you know, with baseball, trying to navigate what's going on right now, what's next for you?
Right now, we're trying to play baseball right now. We've been traveling a lot with Trotsky National. We've been going to Arizona to play some perfect game tournaments, and next for us is Utah.
Okay, checking out Utah. I mean, I've seen pictures of Utah. It looks super cool over there. That'll be a fun experience. One of the questions that I kind of like to wrap up the interviews with when I'm talking to guys who have, you know, gone ahead and committed to Oregon, do you have any kind of a message for Ducks fans, what they can expect from Gabe Howard?
You got to wait those 4 years, and you're gonna see what's happened. Something special is going to happen, and we're moving this baseball. Baseball is going to be big in Eugene now.
Awesome. Baseball is going to be big. Yeah, it's located right next to the football facility, so yep. – you know, people got to keep their eye out on the baseball diamond as well.
Yeah.
Well, hey, Gabe, I can't thank you enough for taking some time to talk to me. Really interesting to get to know about you and Oregon baseball. Stay well, stay safe, and I'll catch you later.
Yeah. Thank you so much. You too. All right. Talk to you later.
All right. See you, Gabe.
Bye.
All right, guys, that'll do it for another interview here on the Scoopduck YouTube channel. If you guys are new here, consider subscribing to the page. I do a lot of videos just like this one, primarily with football prospects and, you know, figures in the football community. But I recently interviewed Ian Umlunt, who is a little bit older than Gabe. He's a class of 2022, and he's committed to come to the University of Oregon and play baseball for the school. So I'll make sure to link that somewhere here on the screen or after I stop rambling here. So wanted to thank Gabe again for taking the time to come talk to me on Zoom. Always interesting to, you know, get some more insight into his life and, you know, what went into his recruitment and the baseball aspect of athletics. You know, working on adding baseball recruiting coverage here on the channel and the site when I can. So with all that being said, if you made it this far, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.